गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कसिंग अबाउट सिस्टर्स अंडर दिस टीनिया सोलियम, टीनिया सार्जिनेटा एंड एकेनोकोकस ग्रैन्युलोसस. सिस्टर्स फर्स्ट, ऑल थ्री और अंडर दिस सिस्टोडा फैमिली includes all tapeworms. It includes all tapeworms. They have suckers and teeth that grasp the host. Behind a short neck or repeated part of the worm, each containing reproductive structures with eggs and sperm, which can be released with the host feces. The feces give the worm of a ribbon-like structure beneficial for absorbing nutrients from the intestine. See, cystoids, adult worm, head with suckers, trunk, strobila, chain of proglottids or segments. Trunk is called strobila. There are two hosts. One is intermediate host and definitive host. Intermediate host, it harbors immature forms of the parasites, insects of herbivorous vertebrate that ingest parasite eggs. Definitive host harbors the mature forms of the parasite, carnivorous or omnivorous mammals that acquires infection by consuming larval cyst in the uncooked tissue of an intermediate host. Tapeworms, scolex, neck, strobila. So the body plan of adult cystoids include a scolex, look like the head, a neck and strobila that can extend for only a few proglottids or thousands. The strobila is not truly metameric, though, as several organs like the excretory system extend through the entire worm. Proglottids, each individual segment. Most worms are very long, occupying the entire length of the small intestine. See, the scolex is the part of the worm that anchors it to the intestinal epithelium and prevents that the worm is passed with the digested food. Different types of scolices. Some cystoids carry a protrusible rostellum which is armed with hooks. These hooks are helpful for to attach to the host epithelium, intestinal epithelium. So muscular hold fast organs include suckers or acetabula, usually 4 per scolex, weakly muscled grooves Bothria, 2 per scolex, and more muscular Bothria, 4 per scolex. Proglottids are budded off from the head and neck region. Proglottids are hermaphroditic eggs producing units. In cross section, the tapeworm body is seen to be filled with parenchyma. Muscle layers separate the body into an outer cortex and inner medulla. The reproductive organs are usually in the medulla. Strobila. In most cystoids, the scolex is tiny when compared to the strobila, which make up most of the actual worms. The strobila consists of a linear series of proglottids. Tapeworms are hermaphrodites and each proglottid carries a set of female and male reproductive organs. Cystoids, there are two types, pseudophyllidian cystoids and cyclophyllidian cystoids. Today topic, Tinea solium, Tinea sarginata and Echinococcus granulosus. These three comes under cyclophyllidian cystoids. Cyclophyllidian means cup-like and round suckers, acetabula. Suckers are round. In upper one, pseudophyllidian cystoid, that slit-like groove, Bothria, that is called Bothria. But in these three, Tinea solium, sarginata, echinococcus, granulosus, suckers, round suckers, and cup-like. First, coming to the echinococcus granulosus. This also called as dog tapeworm. Definitely to host dogs and wolves. Intermediate host, pigs, grazing animals, man occasional, accidental host man. Infective form, eggs. Infected eggs are contaminated to the food material from the definitive host. Mode of transmission, ingestion. Ingestion of contaminated egg. Site of localization, liver, lung, any organ. Echinococcus, echinococcus multilocularis, there are several species are there. Alveolar echinococcus in vasosolid lesions of film consistency, full of connective tissue, a jelly-like material. Echinococcus granulosus, cystic echinococcus produces cystic lesions like that cyst name is hydatid cyst settled in liver, lung and other part of the organs. Echinococcus granulosus, the dog tapeworm. First, here intermediate host, definitive host. Definitive host is dog, intermediate host is sheep and other mammals. Here, see, after passing the eggs from the definitive host, this egg size of the egg is 30 to 37 microns and it is ingested by the sheep through the grazing, grass and contaminated feces from the definitive host, and finally it enters into the GI tract of that mammal, sheep. Finally, it matured to form the cyst, hydatid cyst in the several organs of the body, intermediate host. Adult echinococcus granulosus, adult worms live in the intestine of dogs. They produce eggs which are shed with the feces. Eggs are infected to herbivores and humans accidentally. The oncospia penetrate intestine of intermediate host and develops into a hydatid. Oncospia going to develop hydatid cyst. Hydatids are spherical fluid filled cyst surrounded by a granuloma formed by the host. This hydatid cyst consisting of, there are two layers, exo and endo, middle laminar layer. And inside the hydatid cyst consisting of a fluid consisting of sodium and calcium, salts of succinic acid. That is, when it bursts in the tissue, it causes hypersensitivity reaction. Hydatids can be found in several organs, but are most frequently in the liver. These cysts are 7% in the brain and 10% in the lungs, 66% in the liver, 7% in the kidney, 8% in the abdomen, 2% only in the intraosseous cyst, spreads along medulla by budding outside cyst, semi-solid, no fibrosis. Liver cyst cause liver swelling, right epigastric pain, nausea, vomiting, obstruction of bile duct and blood vessels can cause cholangitis, jaundice, cirrhosis and portal hypertension. So this is the CT scan showing a liver containing hydatid cyst. Next, lung cysts are often well tolerated, but obstruction and or rupture can cause chest pain, cough and dyspnea. The first symptoms of brain cyst is often focal epilepsy. Diagnosis is by serology, radiology, CT scans and sonograms. Treatment is surgical. Prognosis depends on size and location of hydatids. mortality is around 5 to 10%. Hydatids is often injected with sterilizing fluids to avoid metastasis. Benefits of chemotherapy is inconsistent. Sylviatic and domestic strains adapted to dogs and sheep are more aggressive upon human infection. Echinococcus can be locally quite important. Control of feral dogs limit access of dogs to sheep. Often treat pets dogs regularly. Effective control program in many countries includes New Zealand, Tasmania, Cyprus and Iceland. So this is the Echinococcus multilocularis species. Coming to the hydatid cyst. This cyst is outer fibrous capsule host origin. Fibrous capsule parasitic origin and germinal layer. Outside the germinal layer, protoscolizes and daughter cysts are present in the inside interior of the cyst. So sand-like substances. These protoscolizes are sand-like substance present floated into the hydatid fluid. The cyst is lined by multi-layered parasite tissue, with the intermediate layer being the germinal layer. This layer is undifferentiated stem cell layer that can spawn the formation of brood capsule, which are themselves lined by germinal layer. The daughter cyst, the encircled body, bud into the center of the fluid filled cyst. This is very small portion of the cyst, which may become quite large. Each of the smaller bodies will develop into diminutive tapeworm should this be eaten by definitive or final host such as a canine. Thousands of protoscolizes can fill the hydatid sand. Protoscolizes are the infective stage of dogs. Hydatids usually grow slowly but steadily, 1 to 5 centimeters per year. They are usually well tolerated until their size becomes a problem or they rupture. Cyst rupture or leakage can result in allergic reaction and metastasis. Coming to the life cycle of Echinococcus granulosus, intermediate host is, definitive host is dog. Here this intermediate host man, adult worms in the intestine of dogs, definitive host, and eggs are discharged by the definitive host. Eggs are eaten by intermediate host cattle and sheep, herbivores, and accidentally human. Embryo releases from the eggs. Embryo penetrate into the intestinal wall and liver, lung, and any organ. Finally, this hydatid cyst are developed into the intermediate host. This is hydatid cyst or disease. Clinical presentation: non-specific or asymptomatic. 60% right hypochondric pain, 15% jaundice. Others like skin rashes, pruritus, allergic reactions. Cyst can rupture leading to bronchobiliary fistula. Diagnosis: aspiration in contraindicated. Aspiration is contraindicated. X-ray, ultrasonic, CT, MRI, and Casson is intradermal test, skin test. In this skin test, Casson is skin test. Sterile hydatid fluid is injected into the forearm of the patient. And after 24 hours, you can see the indurated form. So if the indurated form is more than 5 mm, the test is positive. And other diagnostic tests are indirect hemagglutination test and ELISA, enzyme linked immunosorbent assay. Drug is not cured to act as agent to kill spilled scoliosis. Praziquantel, albendazole, mebendazole, surgical removal of the cyst. Next, coming to the tinea life cycle. Tinea solium, tinea saginata. Tinea solium also called as pig tapeworm. Tinea saginata is also called as beef tapeworm. Here, intermediate host is first coming to the tinea saginata. Intermediate host is cattle. Definitive host is man in tinea saginata. The length of the worm is 5 meters, maximum 25 meters, up to 25 meters. Infective form is Cysticercus bovis, larval form, Cysticercus bovis. Mode of transmission, ingestion of undercooked meat, undercooked beef that containing larval form of tinea saginata called as Cysticercus bovis. Site of localization, small intestine. Tinea saginata. Beef tapeworm ranges in length from 6 to 30 feet. Geographic distribution, cosmopolitan, most common where poor sanitization and no inspection of meat combined, Africa and South America. Transmission, ingestion of larval form in undercooked beef. In North America, 1 in 100 is infected. In third world nations, could be up to 10%. No symptoms or some abdominal discomfort, abdominal cramps. Diagnosis, finding eggs or proglottids in feces. See the life cycle. In tinea saginata, intermediate host is cattle. Definitive host is man. So man is passing the protoscoliosis segmented and eggs, segmented forms and eggs are released by the definitive host, that is human feces. That human feces containing eggs and the segmented forms are released outside. Human passing the feces outside. So it may be taken by the cattle or other herbivores through the grazing the grass. So cattle, tinea saginata, and in case of pigs, tinea solium, pigs are taken by the feces containing contaminated eggs and that segmented forms. It is strobila. And oncospheres hatch, penetrate intestinal wall and circulate to musculature. So this oncosphere, after this egg is passing into the intestine through the GI tract, through the gastric HCL, it is burst. Upper outer layer is removal by the outer layer, and oncosphere is developed. That oncosphere is going to settle into the tissues as a larval form. Oncosphere develop into Cysticercus in muscles, settled in muscles of cattle. So that is called Cysticercus bovis. So when the human is consumed undercooked, that beef, that again that larval form of Cysticercus bovis entered into the GI tract of definitive host human. So life cycle is repeated. Adult worms are developed into the intestine of human. Human are the only definitive host. Eggs can survive for days or 2 months in the environment. The adult worm attaches by the scolex to the human small intestine. The adult produces proglottids passing with stools. The eggs are released after the proglottids are passed. That segmented forms are called proglottids. The eggs released after the proglottids are passed with the feces. So in case of tinea solium, here pig is the
intermediate or sometimes
definitive host is man.
Pig is the intermediate host. Sometimes this pig also acts as definitive host.
Now, Tinea solium.
Tinea solium has a scolex with four suckers and a double crown of hooks, a narrow neck and large strobula 2 to 4 meter consisting of second diagram, B diagram, that green color, consisting of several hundreds proglottids. About 2 months after ingestion, proglottids begins to detach from the distal end and are excreted in the feces, each segment containing 50 to 60,000 fertile eggs.
Tinea solium.
Endemic in less developed countries where pigs are raised as food source, Latin America, most of Asia, sub-Saharan Africa and parts of Oceania. Infected with the adult forms of the parasite produces similar symptoms to infection with Tinea sarginata. But here Tinea solium is one of the complication neurocysticercosis. Neurocysticercosis cyst forms are seen in the brain, that is called neurocysticercosis, one of the major complications. That is difference between Tinea sarginata and Tinea solium. Tinea sarginata, that is that doesn't produce any complications. Tinea solium produces complications, and the length of the worm and scolex differences, hooks differences between hooks and larval forms in Tinea solium, we call it as cysticercus cellulosa. Larval forms in Tinea sarginata, we call it as cysticercus bovis.
Here cysticerci, first a diagram, cysticerci as seen in infected pork excised into a petri dish, the white dot in each cyst corresponds to the scolex, the lancet. Human cysticercosis. When human plays the role of the intermediate host, larval stage develop into the human host. Human acquires cysticercosis through fecal-oral contamination with Tinea solium eggs.
Oncosphere in the eggs is released by the action of gastric acid and intestinal fluids, cross the gut wall and enters the bloodstream. They are carried to the muscles and other tissues. They encyst as cysticerci at small terminal vessels 1 cm A and B. Neurocysticercosis and ophthalmic cysticercosis is serious complication.
Neurocysticercosis. The parasite infects the central nervous system, epileptic seizures 58 to 80% when parenchymal brain cyst, intracranial hypertension, hydrocephalus or both.
This syndrome is related to the location of parasites in the cerebral ventricles or vessel system. Occasionally, a cyst may grow larger, giant cyst. Geographical variation in clinical manifestation. Cysts are rounded or oval vesicles from a few mm to 1 to 2 cm. Most common location is in the cerebral hemisphere, mainly at the junction of gray and white matter. Cysts can be found in the cerebellum, ventricles, brainstem, basal cistern and spine. Viable cysts have a translucent membrane through which the scolex is visible. Cysts degenerate, the fluid becomes opaque and dense, edges irregular and shrinks. Calcification starts in the cephalic portion and leaves a whitish calcified nodules. That nodules are visualized in CT, computerized tomography, where the location cysts are located in brain and ophthalmic.
Diagnosis.
Serology. Serologic diagnosis. Antibody assay for cysticercosis. Antigen detection assay. Circulating antigen means a live parasite, ongoing viable infection. monoclonal antibodies seems to detect antigens in cerebrospinal fluid. Antibody assays for tinnitus TSE-33 and TSE-38 were recognized by a panel of tinnitus but not cysticercosis. Patient serum sample. Neuroimaging diagnosis CT and MRI provide objective evidence on number and location of cysticerci. Also, their viability and the severity of the post-inflammatory reaction. Cysticercosis treatment. Treatment should be individualized based on cyst location, level of inflammation, and clinical presentation. Therapy should include analgesic, anti-epileptic drugs, cysticercal drugs, surgical resection of lesions, and placements of ventricular shunt. Parenchymal cysticercosis with viable cyst, albendazole 15 mg with dexamethasone, praziquantel, or the drug of choice. Subarachnoid cysticercosis, anti-parasitic therapy. No reason to use anti-parasitic drugs to treat dead calcified cyst. Symptomatic therapy, surgical therapy, ventricular shunting to resolve hydrocephalus, also excision of giant cyst or intraventricular cyst. We don't get neurocysticercosis by eating pork. Ingestion of infected pork only causes adult tame form infestation, tinnitus, that is. So that infected larval form, infected pork, larval stage, cysticercus cellulosa. Infected pork containing only the larval cysts that develop into adult worm in the human intestine. What is that transmits cysticercosis? The eggs, most common source of infected eggs, a symptom free tapeworm carries in the household. So this is the life cycle of tinea saginata, adult worm, intestine. So egg, stool, cattle ingest, oncosphere released, intestinal penetration, blood to blood to muscle, through the circulation settled into the muscle, that is called cysticercus bovis, bladder larva. Man eat undercooked beef, that scoliosis release in the intestine, the life cycle is repeated. So intermediate host is cattle, definitive host is human. Diagnosis, this is digestive disturbances, diagnosis eggs, segments in stool. Tinea solium, definitive host man, intermediate host pig. Infective form cysticercus cellulosa, eggs, mode of transmission ingestion, site of localization intestine. So here definitive host is man and intermediate host pig. So man is infected by the consumption of undercooked pork, that is pork containing cysticercus cellulosa, measly pork. So that pork, after ingesting through the gastric juices and intestinal fluids, its egg, that larva containing that larval forms are going to develop adult worms. So adult worms in the intestine of pig, adult worm of intestine a pig ingest, oncosphere released, intestinal penetration, blood to muscle, and cysticercus cellulosa, bladder larva. Man eat undercooked pork, that scolex released into the intestine, that life cycle is repeated. Diagnosis, this is digestive disturbances, neurocysticercosis 60%. Diagnosis, eggs, segments in stool, ultrasonography, CT, MRI, ELISA, drug of choice, niclosamide, praziquantel, and albendazole. Tinea solium, see, this is the diagram showing Tinea solium, lateral branches of uterus 7 to 13. Tinea saginata, lateral branches of uterus 15 to 20. So that is the one of the difference completed. Thank you.